Hello, I'm Rawn Clark. Today we'll be exploring the paths of Gedulah, the three paths that create Gedulah. First will be from Kether to Gedulah, and that's the first of our hidden paths. And as I explained before, there is no assigned symbols to the hidden paths. They are very much an individual exploration. So I call this one HP for hidden path.
1 to 5.
Kether to Gedulah. Second one will be the path of Gimmel from Chokmah to Gedulah. And then last is the path of Teth from Tifereth to Gedulah. Okay, so HP.
1 to 5.
We start in Kether. And we end up in Gedulah, and we travel back to Kether. So, I will jump right in. Ooh, the eye. The infinite eye. Nothing but eye. Everything. Down towards Gedulah, the realm of the individual self that's connected to all things. And I walk down this path. Ooh, and I'm falling like big, juicy flakes of snow. Falling gently upon a snow-covered field. Gently, gently I descend to Gedulah. Oh, and I see how everything is connected and perfect. Perfect. Everything is in its place, connected with everything else. Gedulah feels like home, where I am in my perfect place, connected with everything. Everywhere I look, I see and I am connected to all things, and all things are connected to me. We fit together perfectly in an absolute symmetrical ordering. It's all so perfect. Everything is right. Everything is okay. It all fits together smoothly, perfectly, beautifully. Kether, and there's this beautiful snow falling down upon me, little particles of Kether brilliance. Ooh. It's also loving and benign. Oh, and I travel up into it, into this ever-increasing love, this ever-increasing, encompassing white brilliance. For me, the main thing about this path is loving-kindness, the generous beauty and affection that I feel in Gedulah coming from Kether, descending from Kether. So, our next path is the path of Gimel. Now, the letter Gimmel means camel, which is very significant in the region that Hebrew originated. Desert, basically, where camel was the main transport, the main transport for commerce, specifically. And it can go long distances, long time in the desert without water. It stores its own water and brings it with it. The astrological attribution is the planet Jupiter, the second of our planetary paths. Okay, and it starts from Hokma and goes to Gedulah. So, Hokma. Central meaning. Ooh, I am. I am. I mean, I must express my meaning in whatever way possible. I express my meaning, infinite meaning, the meaning of the I, of the one self. I am filled with all this meaning, and I express this meaning. And I look down to Gedulah. To Gedulah, loving kindness. And I descend into Gedulah. I fall like water onto Gedulah. And I make the ground of Gedulah fertile. And my meaning, it all erupts from the ground of Gedulah. It's all connected. It's all meaning. Oh, all meaning connected together. Oh, and it's all perfect in its place, in its order. Oh, I bless Gedulah with kindness, compassion, mercy. It all comes from me, from Hokma, from the meaning that fills Gedulah and connects everything. Everything has meaning, and that meaning is connected. It's all in its perfect place, its perfect time, in its perfect way. And I look up from Gedulah towards Jupiter, towards Hokma. And on this path upwards, there are all these images. Ooh, all these faces of meaning, every meaning has an image, has a face. Each expresses its meaning. I travel back up to all meaning. Ooh, here there is no separation between. Filled with gathering brilliance, filled with meaning. This is truly the path of evocation, where everything is represented, each meaning is represented by an image, each thing has its own meaning and its own personality, as it were. Okay. The next path is the path of Teth. The letter Teth means basket or snake. It's the snake that's coiled, or a basket. The best meaning is really the snake that's coiled, because it has a very snake energy to it. The astrological attribution is Leo, the sign Leo, ruled by the sun. It is the only zodiacal sign ruled by the sun, like Teth was ruled by the moon. This letter is ruled by the sun, and it's the sign Leo. So, here we go. It runs from Tiferet to Gedulah. Tiferet, the realm of individual selves. Tiferet. So beautiful. These beautiful gems of individual selves, each one a little eye. Solar light radiates down into Gedulah by the path of Teth, of Leo. I descend. I bring the light of my individual self into the realm of Gedulah. Everything is connected. I shine my individual light into the realm of Gedulah. I shine it into this connection with everything. It is my connection to everything else is through the light of my individual self. I bring my sunshine to the world. All of us together, we create such brilliant light, such a perfect, beautiful shine. Everything radiates its own individual light here in Gedulah. It is so beautiful. And I look back up towards Tiferet. And I stream back up. In this beautiful, beautiful light of all the individual selves. And I am the light in Tiferet, which shines in this realm, in this temporal realm, this realm of time and space. I shine my light. We shine. The overriding thing in that path is the individual, the light of the individual self shining down into Gedulah and mixing with all the other lights. Okay, that does it for today. Next time, we're going to be the paths of Gebura. And there are four paths to Gebura. So, till next time. Bye-bye.